So welcome to today's lesson. So on today's lesson, we are going to learn how to do the Gaussian elimination using partial pivoting. And we are going to illustrate that with this question here. You realize that with our Gaussian elimination, we said that one of the problems you can face is when you have division by zero and division by a very, very smaller number. So these are two main challenges that we encounter using the naive Gaussian elimination. So in order to correct this, then we introduce pivoting strategies, and we have types of them. So we'll be talking about the partial pivoting. So whenever we have this system of matrices, what we do first is that we form our coefficient matrix and our vector b. So this is our coefficient matrix and it's our vector b. Then after finding for our coefficient matrix, you know, we try to reduce this to an upper triangular matrix, right? And with the partial pivoting, the first question we ask ourselves is, when you take our first column here, we try to make the leading coefficient here the largest. So realize that with our first column, we have 3, 2, 1. This happens to be the largest, so we will maintain it. If let's say we're having 3 here and 2 here, then we'd have changed rules. So we'd have changed rule 2 and rule 3. But since already the element here is the largest, then we are good to go. Because we are going to divide through by this, and this is the largest. So you realize that we have avoided one of the problems here, that's division by 0. So we then form our elementary matrix. Our first elementary matrix is giving us 1, 0, 0, and we have our multipliers here. So the reason we have our multipliers here is that, you see, when you are doing our first Gaussian transformation, we try to reduce everything beneath our E11. So we try to reduce it to 0. So that's the reason we have our multipliers here. So our M21 is giving us A21 over E11. So our A21 is 2, our E11 is 3. And our M31 is giving us E31 over E11. So E31 is 1 and our E11 is 3. So that means that our M21 is 2 over 3. Our M31 is 1 over 3. So we can form our first elementary matrix here. Sorry. So with our first elementary matrix, we're going to get M1 to be equal to 1, 0, 0. Now our negative M2, 1 gives us this. Our negative M31 gives us this. So that means we are done forming our first elementary matrix. And our first Gaussian transformation is giving us A1 because we are finding for the first Gaussian transformation. So we name it A1 will be equal to our first elementary matrix. That is M1 times our original A. So remember, this was our M1 and this was our original A. When you do this matrix multiplication, you're going to end up with this. So that means this is what you're going to get from our first Gaussian transformation. And you realize that here, whatever is beneath our E11 here has been reduced to 0, just like the normal thing we've been using Gaussian elimination to do. But here we are trying to avoid division by 0 and division by a very smaller number. So the next thing we do is that you see, now we've gotten this, our first transformation Gaussian matrix. So we ask ourselves, so the next thing is to come here and make what is beneath this 0. So we come here and we ask ourselves, between A22 and A32, which of them is the largest? So you realize that this here is larger than this here. So when we decide just to go straight for it, then that means that our M32 is going to be 14 over 3 divided by 1 over 3. And you realize that here we are doing division by a smaller number. 1 over 3 is smaller than 14 over 3. So this is what partial pivoting or pivoting strategies try to avoid. So what we do is that we swap rule 2 and rule 3. So that instead of dividing by 1 over 3, we are going to divide by 14 over 3. So you swap rule 2 and rule 3. So when we do that, that means we are going to get our A noun to be 31200. So this our second rule becomes, this our third rule becomes our second rule, and our second rule becomes our third rule, so that we get something of this form. So the next thing will be for us to find our second elementary matrix, and our second elementary matrix is giving us m2 equals 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0 minus m3, 2, 1. So remember that here we just want to make whatever is here 0. So that's why we have our multiplier here. And our m3, 2 is given as a3, 2 over a2, 2. And you realize that when we swap our rows, now our a3, 2 became 1 over 3 and our a2, 2 became 14 over 3. So we are dividing by a larger number instead of a smaller number. So that's what the pivoting strategies do. They help us to avoid division by 0 and division by a very small number. Then, that means when we do that, we are going to get, we are going to get our elementary matrix to be this 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, and this is minus m3, 2, 1. So our second Gaussian transformation matrix is just our second elementary matrix m2 times our first Gaussian transformation a1, and these are the two. So you multiply these two matrices and we get this. We realize that here, this particular matrix here has been reduced to what? The upper triangular form. So that means you are good to go, just like what you would have done, use the Gaussian elimination to do. And I return our attention to where we have our constant, B. So whatever you did for the A to the A matrix, you have to do the same thing to our B vector. So we realize that with the first one, we said our A1 was equal to M1A. So that means that our B1 will also be equal to M1B. So that's what you find here. So when you do that, you're going to get this particular vector here. And when we had this particular vector, what we did is that we swapped row 2 and row 3. Do you remember? In the A, we swapped row 2 and row 3. So that means here too, you have to swap row 2 and row 3 so that we get this thing that we have here. So after that, you realize, so that's why I wrote here, swap root 2 and root 3. So after that, our A2 was equal to M2A1. So now in place of the A, we use our B. And when we do that, we are going to get this matrix vector multiplication, which is going to give us this particular vector. So that means now we are going to have this augmented matrix, which is going to be A2/B2. That's our transformations. So this is our A2 and this is our B. You realize that since we have this now, then we can use our backward substitution to find x1, x2, and x3. So that means now we are going to have this, which happens to be our upper triangular matrix times our x is equals our B. And when you use backward substitution to solve this problem, you're going to get x1 to be this, x2 to be this, and x3 to be this. So thank you very much. And this is how we use the partial pivoting to solve systems of linear equation. So when you get your final answer, you can verify to see whether what you've gotten is correct or not. Thank you.